Hey everyone, welcome to No Ideas Media. I'm Nick Syke, and I gotta say I'm pretty happy about some major news that happened recently. CRISPR won't be regulated as a GMO. That's huge. Now, for those of you who know what I'm talking about, good on you. Share this video with somebody who has no idea what CRISPR is, besides maybe a drawer for vegetables in their fridge. So here's the deal with this CRISPR thing. All it is a technique to alter the genetics of our food, and for a number of reasons, it's a pretty awesome technique. Here's the Reader's Digest version. CRISPR stands for Clustered Regularly Interspaced Short Palindromic Repeats. It's just a pattern in DNA. You can think of it like genetic bookends. Whatever sequence of base pairs a scientist puts between those clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats sort of gets saved, easily referenced. And this mechanism is a totally typical part of prokaryotic function. So if you take a peek inside bacteria as an example, you'd see CRISPR in action, naturally. Scientists have taken the best parts of this mechanism and some other ones to create a better method of genome editing. Because it's easy to reference, it acts like a roadmap. You know you're in the right spot if you see this pattern. The other important mechanism here is an enzyme called Cas9. Now, Cas enzymes come in different types, and there is a lot of nuance to how they can be used and what they can be used for. But for the purposes of this simple explanation, you can think of Cas9 kind of like a pair of genetic scissors. So you've got a roadmap showing you where you're headed and a pair of scissors for when you get there. You have everything you need to engineer a genome. Cool. So what happens is this little section of RNA with the CRISPR map floats along the target DNA until it sees a pattern that matches its saved CRISPR map. This part is more or less just like a really accurate DNA GPS system. It's saying, you arrived at your destination. What do you want to do now? Well, now you get out your Cas9 scissors. Cas9 follows the map exactly to the spot where you want it to cut the target DNA, and it does that. So you've snipped your target DNA. Now what? Well, the cell hosting these DNA arts and crafts is going to realize its DNA has been snipped. It happens from time to time, no trouble. The cell has mechanisms to repair the damaged DNA. Those mechanisms are sent into action. Maybe you made two snips and just removed a section of DNA, or maybe you added something or whatever. It doesn't really matter what you want to do. The point is the cell itself is going to put everything back together for you. There you go, just deep enough to confuse the heck out of normal people and just shallow enough to piss off all the scientists who could have probably explained it better. Rock in a hard place. But the thing about this system that has science all in a tizzy is that we've never had as accurate a DNA mapping system as this. Arriving at our genetic destination has always been a bit of a guessing game, or at least a game of trial and error. Like, maybe previous techniques were like GPS systems with an accuracy of 100 meters, give or take, whereas CRISPR-Cas9 systems is like GPS with like millimeter precision. It's so much more accurate than what we've had before. And it's also so much cheaper, like orders of magnitude less expensive than other techniques. It's fast, it's cheap, and it's high quality, and that is no small feat. Another part of this that was also no small feat, scientists were able to communicate all of this to the USDA, who said in a statement that they have no plans to regulate crops, quote, that could otherwise have been developed through traditional breeding techniques. Okay, so what? CRISPR does not sound like traditional breeding, and it's not traditional breeding. They are different. But the thing is, using CRISPR to make changes to genes doesn't necessarily mean adding any other DNA to an organism. In many cases, all you're doing is snipping out things or moving things around, but not adding anything. This means that what you can do with CRISPR can absolutely be something the plant could have done on its own eventually. Okay, so all of this stuff, when you put it in like a dollars and cents context, basically just means the substantial regulatory roadblocks that exist for genetically engineered or transgenic crops just aren't a problem for CRISPR. And that means that getting new CRISPR crops to market is gonna be so much cheaper than trying to deregulate a transgenic crop. And it'll be faster too, which means we're gonna see some really cool stuff in the next few years. And that cool stuff will make its way to our plate, and that's gonna be awesome. Thanks for watching.